There is a cruel dilemma when you choose a web scraping tool. This dilemma is between how easy the tool is and how far I can go with the tool. You don't want a tool which is too easy because it will probably not solve a specific problem, but you don't want a tool which is too difficult either because it will take years before you even master it. And the tool we're going to talk about fits right in the middle, Octoparse. Octoparse has got another advantage. It's a freemium tool. Usually speaking, we consider that the free plan, which is the one we will base this tutorial on, is perfect for individuals. On the other hand, the premium plan fits well for companies. Hi, I'm Francois. I worked for Octoparse for about a year, and on this video, I will teach you everything you need to know to create your first task on Octoparse. We will also see what common mistakes beginners usually do and how you can easily avoid them. You can download Octoparse. It's available both for Windows and Mac users. The link is in the description. We are on Octoparse. Before we even start a project, you need to know a couple of things. We've got three important tabs on Octoparse. The first one is the popular task templates, and it's something we won't see on this tutorial because you can only use templates if you've got a premium plan. Then you've got the home page, and on this page, we will create our tasks by entering URLs. And finally, we've got our dashboard, which is the most important tab in Octoparse. And you can see there all the tasks you have been created so far. So if you need to update something, you just need to click on one task and then you can make your change. On this tutorial, I'm going to script teachers' jobs in London based on this particular website. So I'm going to script the title, the wage, the contract, and then we're going to click on each of the article, kind of, in order to extract further info, like the date or the URL of the job posts and the description. So the very first thing we need to do is to copy our URL and to paste it on Octoparse, and I click on start. As you can notice, your task is divided into three parts. You've got the visual of your website, you've got the data preview part, and it's the place in which you will see your final data, at least a preview of your final data. And the most important part is your workflow, and it's the place in which we will create our automation. So let's start our pagination first. But before that, we need to remove this pop-up. In order to remove your pop-up, you've got what we call the browse mode. If you turn on the browse mode, you are able to click on accept, or let's say customize, reject all. And now I simply remove the pop-up. I don't forget to turn off the browse mode right away. So why are we doing the pagination, by the way? The pagination helps us to extract data on multiple pages, because the problem is if we extract this page, we will get something like 25 job posts, which is the reason why we will click on the next page button each time. In other words, we will script data as long as there is a next page button. To create a pagination, the process is very simple, but at the same time, it's pretty tricky. I need you to click on the next page button, just like this. And then you've got some tips on what we call the tips panel. The first thing you need to verify is to make sure that you've got an A here or a button, one of them. The A represents a URL, and the button represents a button, obviously. If I didn't select the A element, for instance, I selected the span element, that's okay because I can just say, no, I don't want to select the span element. I want to select the A element instead. Once we have done that, I can create a loop. I click on loop, click single URL, and I've got my pagination. That's a mistake number one you can easily avoid. Then Octoparse is asking about an Ajax timeout. I suggest you set up the highest timeout, so like 10 seconds. We need to scrape all 25 elements, all 25 job posts on each page. And this is the reason why we need to create another loop, but this time it will be a loop item. I click on pagination in order to make sure my loop item will be inserted within my pagination. And you've got multiple ways to create a loop item, so we will see one particular method. I select my first element and I select the entire element. I don't click on here, I don't click on here. I select the entire element. So I click on it. There it goes. And I repeat the same process on the second element, just like this. And let's see what happens. Octoparse notices that we've got 25 similar elements, and all of these elements have been selected in green, and all sub-elements highlighted in red is possible data willing to be extracted. So I can click and select all sub-elements in order to extract all of this data. And then I click on extract data. And the exciting part is that we've got both our loop item and our extract data step at the same time. The first thing we need to do is to drag our loop item just above the click to paginate step. That's mistake number two you can easily avoid. Something which is important as well is that you clean your data a little bit. The field one colon is not necessary. So if I need to delete a colon, I click on more and delete field. By the way, there is something I forget to tell you. I suggest you go to the settings and you skip the delete confirmation dialog. We've got the title, which is something interesting. I double click and I can edit this colon and call it title. If I need to remove multiple colons at the same time, because we've got a lot of colons, I can switch to the vertical view and I'm able to delete multiple colons at the same time. So let's delete all of this and I delete fields. What is this? I don't know, it doesn't seem necessary. And we've got the permanent full time, which is the contract. So that's necessary. I've got the place. I don't want to keep it, but it's up to you. I've got the wage. Okay, I keep this colon. I've got the URL of the company name. I don't need this. I've got the company name. Okay. I've got the date, but as I've said earlier, we will extract the date directly on the detail page. So I don't need that colon either. And I don't need this colon. And now we can jump into the detail page. So how can we do that? We can simply add a click item element after the extract data step. Let's do it. So I click on what seems to be the URL leading to the detail page. Usually speaking, it's often located within the title. So I click on the title, and as you can notice, I've got an A element which represents a URL. I need to click on click URL. You've got two options when you add a click item part. If you go to the options, you can see that Octoparse checks the open in a new tab box. But in some cases, you can get load with Ajax checked. What I'm going to show you only works if Octoparse checks the open in a new tab box. If you've got load with Ajax instead, it won't work, or at least it won't work this way. We talked about the date, so okay, I click on this, and we've got the date plus the company. What about the page URL? The page URL is a bit specific, but it's very easy to do. I click on add custom field, page of a data, and page URL. And I've got the URL of each title page. What about the description? It seems that I cannot extract the entire description. I can extract this, something like this, but I will get all of this data as well. So what I can do is to extract the we can offer you data, and then I can move on within the similar elements. So I can click on span. No, not that one. I can click on P. No, span. Maybe div. And I've got the div part. If I click on div, as you can see, we've got the entire description part. I click on extract text of the selected element. We've got the description. So the click item part was the mistake number 3 you can easily avoid. And finally, you've got the mistake number 4. And it's all about the extract data one step. If you extract a detail page, I strongly suggest you to add a timeout. So I go to options for the extract data one step, and I add a timeout of around 10 seconds. All that remains to do is to run the task. We click on the standard mode. I can click on show browser in order to verify what happens in my browser. So I will wait a little bit and I see you back for the results. I'm going to stop the task now. Of course, if you need a comprehensive set of data, you need to wait until the task is completed. But as an example, I think our test is a success. I stop my task, I confirm, and I click on export data. And I'm going to export my data in an Excel spreadsheet. And here is the result. This is the end of the video. I hope you have enjoyed it, or at least you have learned something new about web scraping. You can give a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel if you want to. And if you need any help regarding Octoparse and web scraping, you can ask for a coaching session or asking for a quote by sending me an email. I hope to see you soon.